This is trigonometry objective worksheet question number 56. Now I'll just I'm not going to write the detailed steps because it is given in the module. I'll just tell you the flow you have to follow in this question. Now we assume left hand side. Left hand side is of this type where we have sine sum of three sine terms. So we assume that as LHS. The very first step we take is we take square of this, and when we take square of this, you know this formula a plus b plus c whole square. It's an identity. A plus b plus c whole square is a square is like a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2c into a. So 2 into product of terms taken two at a time, right? First of all, squares of the individual terms, and then two times product of terms taken two at a time. So this, you know this formula from your earlier classes. Now when we apply this formula, like on this part we apply 2 sine a sine b formula. 2 sine a sine b is cos a minus b minus cos a plus b, right? I write here 2 sine a sine b is the formula cos a minus b minus cos a plus b, right? Using this formula we write every term in terms of two terms. Use this formula, we can split this terms into two cosine terms, 1 plus 1 minus. Same, we split this term into two cosine terms, and you will see that so there will be 3 plus terms, there will be 3 minus terms, all terms will cancel out, and this part will become 0, right? So we are left with only this part, and on this part we apply formula. We apply sine square a formula. Sine square is 1 minus cos double angle divided by 2. So these formulas are double angle formulas, right? So we apply this formula on each and every term to get this. We take three constant term out, and then we have sum of three cosine terms. I've written the terms specifically to show you something. Now see, I convert this angle. I use this formula. Cos of theta can be written as cos of 2 pi minus theta, right? Because you know cos theta is same as cos of minus theta, and then I have added 2 pi to this angle. I can add 2 pi to every trigonometric angle, right? So I can change cos theta to cos 2 pi minus theta, and if I do this with this term will become 2 pi by 7. Now you can see first of all cos 2 pi by 7, then cos 4 pi by 7, and then cos 8 pi by 7. So we change it to cos 2 pi by 7. Similarly we change this to cos 6 pi by 7. Again the same logic, and this is 4 pi by 7. Now you can see cos 2 pi by 7, cos 4 pi by 7, cos 6 pi by 7. We have sum of three cosine terms where angles are in AP, 2 pi, and if I add 2 pi to 2 pi by 7 it becomes 4 pi by 7. I again add 2 pi by 7 to 4 pi by 7, it becomes 6 pi by 7. So angles are in arithmetic progression. Sum of cosine terms, angles are in arithmetic progression. We have a formula. You apply this formula and you will get the answer. I hope it helps.